they say, trust us. We can modify seeds to be more productive and create herbicides to work with those seeds. Trust us.
Hello.
Okay. Can we trust Monsanto with our food supplies? Can we trust Monsanto to be honest? Can we learn from their past to know whether they can be trusted? Trusted to be honest and truthful. Trusted with our health, our environment, our food supply. Let me tell you about my dad, Doug Clark. 12 years ago, he was 60 years old, a marathon runner. He was hiking the Appalachian Trail and had completed 2,000 miles and had only 175 miles to go. He was an avid cyclist, full of energy. He couldn't sit still, always on the go, full of life, looking forward to a long, healthy retirement. 2 years later, he was diagnosed with a very aggressive prostate cancer, so aggressive that it required the most aggressive radiation treatment that MD Anderson could give him. So what happened? Why did he get the most aggressive form of prostate cancer? Monsanto happened. 50 years ago, my dad served his country in Vietnam. He was an airplane mechanic in the Air Force. While my dad was fixing planes, Monsanto was making millions selling a toxic broom known as Agent Orange for the military used in Vietnam. After being initially treated with high doses of radiation, my dad's cancer was put in check, or so we thought. But it lingered. He began to try to live normally, resumed hiking on the AT. He even ran a 10K with me in Atlanta. I still can't keep up with him. But the cancer never went away. It lurked in his body. He would never finish the Appalachian Trail. The cancer eventually spread to his bones. He endured hormone treatment, experimental treatment, and many different types of shots and pills. Meanwhile, the pain increased. 2 years ago, his Veterans Administration doctor begged him to start chemo. But he was too proud to share his situation with his family. He hid his pain from everyone, suffering in isolation, blaming his sciatica for his limp. I knew he had prostate cancer, like a lot of older men. That is not uncommon. Some don't even seek treatment. What is uncommon is being diagnosed with this highly aggressive form of prostate cancer at 62 years old that was caused by his exposure to Monsanto's Agent Orange 50 years ago in Vietnam. My dad, conqueror of the Boston Marathon, died 2 months ago from cancer caused by toxic brew made by Monsanto. The U.S. was looking for ways to weaken and then defeat the Viet Cong. The Viet Cong could hide in the jungle. They could get food from remote farming villages. The U.S. government thought, we can destroy the forest. We can kill the farmers' crops. So the government ordered a combination of two pesticides that would kill the forest and kill the crops. Monsanto became the biggest supplier of this herbicide. But in manufacturing the herbicide, a third byproduct was created, dioxin. Dioxin is one of the most toxic chemicals known to man. It is a very deadly carcinogen, even in very small concentrations. Of all the companies making Agent Orange, Monsanto produced Agent Orange with the highest percentage of dioxin. Monsanto knew this. They also knew they would make less money if they were more careful, slowed their production down, and reduced the level of dioxin. Monsanto also knew that the dioxin was deadly because they saw their own employees getting sick. But they knew that if they were more careful, it would affect their bottom line. Agent Orange was sprayed from boats, helicopters, airplanes, and back to pickup trucks. Vietnam was saturated with over 19 million gallons of Agent Orange. And Monsanto was making a fortune selling this toxic fruit. Monsanto was killing American soldiers, the Vietnamese people, and they were starving the rural farming villages by poisoning their crops and their soil. To date, the Red Cross in Vietnam estimates there are more than 3 million victims of Agent Orange, of which 400,000 at least have already died. And some of those victims are born with one or more missing limbs, some with no eyes, and many other deformities. While Monsanto was killing and maiming generations of people, they were also making a killing. Monsanto and Dow knew about dioxin, but they chose not to tell our government. They kept quiet. Ironically, Monsanto now says they are a change company and they only want to help make seeds. Monsanto is now back in Vietnam peddling GMO seeds to Vietnamese farmers when 50 years ago they were complicit in killing their crops. Now they say, we want to help you grow crops, not kill them. Just trust us. Our U.S. government now admits they were complicit in poisoning our soldiers with Agent Orange. My dad received 100% disability rating, and the VA provided him with excellent care. I got to spend the last month of his life going to the VA with him for his doctor's appointment. I was shocked at what I heard and saw there. He was just one of so many of our Vietnam veterans suffering from Agent Orange. He was not alone in dying a very painful death. At the VA, I saw some veterans in wheelchairs, some with oxygen tanks, others receiving chemotherapy alongside my dad. They would warmly greet one another, thanking one another for their service to our country. We know Monsanto's Agent Orange causes aggressive forms of prostate cancer, Parkinson's disease, heart disease, and many other cancers and diseases. There are too many to list. We know, as children of Vietnam veterans, that Agent Orange has caused birth defects, such as spina bifida, various autoimmune disorders, Crohn's disease, and other diseases in us, the children of Vietnam veterans. What we don't know is what other effects this dioxin will have on us as we get older and on our children as we watch them grow up. In Vietnam, the majority of Agent Orange was stored at Da Nang Air Force Base. Today, 50 years later, the airbase is one of the most contaminated places in the world. There is finally an effort to clean it up, so dioxin no longer invades and poisons the food chain and water supply control of the next. 50 years later, 50 years from now, are we going to be caring for the victims of the GMO experiment gone bad? Will Monsanto disclose test results that show a product is dangerous and toxic? 50 years from now, what environment will be destroyed? What diseases will we be facing? If that happens, I know Monsanto will once again blame someone else and say, we are now a new change company. Just trust us.